Hello guys, welcome to the OS concept video series for placement and interview preparation. In previous video, we have discussed about the concept of class. In today video, we will discuss about the object, the concept of object. So basically, in previous video, we have already covered the class concept. That means the class is a blueprint of an object. That means virtual things, class is a virtual thing and object is a real thing. So basically object means it has some memory in memory, system memory. That means it has some system memory. So whenever we are talking about the objects, that means it occupies some space in memory. So the memory block or the space is known as object, and it may be it is the real life implementation of class. So basically if we talk about the definition of object, so basically a object is a real life implementation of the class, and object refer to the instance of the class. Instance of a class means whenever we declare integer A. That means there is a memory, and some memory like the size of integer, it will be allocated for this variable A. That means this memory is a instance of this variable. Similarly, whenever we create an object, so the memory for all the members for that class is allocated in the memory, and that memory is known as object. So object is a real life implementation, or you can say object is a instance of that class. So we can create the object with the help of new keyword in Java. So I already told you that Java is a pure object oriented, so we cannot do any kind of work without object. So for creating object, we need a new keyword. After new keyword, we have a constructor or a class name. So whenever we say that we have defined a constructor, so we can call with the help of constructor. And whenever we don't have any constructor, so we create class like this, object like this. That means there is a default constructor which is automatically defined by the compiler. So we are actually calling the default constructor. So we will discuss about the constructor in detail when we will discuss the constructor concept. So here I just want to explain the object. So object, that means I have defined a class which has two private members. That means string color. I have defined a class car which has let's say color and model number. These are the two variables, and I haven't complete the whole class. Like it might have the functionality that how to drive and how to brake, how to number of wheels, color, model, and number of seats, space and dimensions. So it may have multiple fields, but for demonstration I have just select some fields. Like I have taken two fields for instance variable like string color and integer model number. And I have a constructor, I have defined a constructor which can take two arguments, that means a string and integer, and it can initialize these two variables, that means color equals to color. And I have used this keyword. Why this keyword? Because this color and this color both are same. So this is the concept of data shadowing. So we will discuss about data shadowing as well as data hiding in detail in later videos. But here you should understand, whenever we are using the same variable name in class level and local level, these are the local level variables and these are the class level variables. So priority goes to local variable. That means if we don't use this keyword, then this color and this color refer to this color only. So we have to use this keyword which can refer the variable to the class level variable. So we will discuss about it in later videos, so don't worry about it. And we have a function boy display which can display the color and a model number. So it might be possible that we have multiple functions, like we have only display functions, we have multiple functions how to drive, how to brake and so on, and we have multiple properties like color, shape, size and so on. So for demonstration I have taken few of them. And there is another class that means main class. So as all of we know that every program starts running from main method. So we have defined a main method here. For in Java we have to define like this: public static void main. This is the fix. We cannot change public static void main. It is same, and it takes an argument of string type array. So it should be string, or it may be arg, or whatever name you. It is not fixed that you have to use args. You can use anything, like you can use like this a only. So it is the string type of array, and we are creating a class. We are creating an object. Why writing this line? Car. Car means the class name. Car. C. So C is a reference variable, or you can say in C++, C is a pointer which can point to the object of that class. So here we don't have a pointer in Java. So here is a reference variable. Reference variable means same as pointer, which can refer or which can point to the object of car class. So when we write this line, so there is a memory. So a small block for this class object is allocated with the two variables name. That means this is the constructor. So whenever we have to write this line, so this constructor will call. So it will pass color equals to red and model equals to 1001. So there will be two part four variables, like here color red and here the model number 1001. And there are multiple fields, so the more space will be for that, and there are stack for function calling. So this object or this memory is allocated for this class, and this is known as object. So object is a real life entity which is exist inside the memory, real. So basically class is a conceptual view, or class is a blueprint of object, and object is a real life implementation of that class. So whenever we have write this line, we have written this line, that means we are creating an object of class car with the initial value of red and 1001. So we can again create another variable with another color and another model number and so on. And we can call all the members. We can access all the members and member functions. Members means that data type or data the value instance variables, and member function means the function which is defined inside that class. So we can access data members and member function with the help of dot operator. So C is a reference variable. That means C is pointing to this object. So C dot display, and display function call, and display function can display both. That means color and model number. So it will print color, that means red, and in new line 1001. So this will be printed with the this function, that means display function. So basically we have a main class, and we are creating an object of car class inside main class. So don't confuse, we can use main function inside it also, or we can use main function inside any class. But whenever we have defined a public static void main inside any class, the program start execution from that main function. So it might be possible we can define multiple classes in a single file, but we can define only main function only in a single class. So we cannot define main function in each class. So we can it may be like this, that first of all we will define this class, after that we will define this public public class main, after that we will define this thing. So you will get the full code in programming solution Android app. So don't forget to download it. It is available on Google Play Store. So you can Android user simply search on Google Play Store and programming solution, you will get it. Otherwise I will also provide the link in description, so you can download it, and you can access all the content regarding OOFs, as well as for your written interview, as well as for your written exam, coding exam, and for your GATE preparation. So all concepts and all programming and theory concepts are there in programming solution Android app. So you can download it. And the object I have explained you, the relationship between class and object. So object, you will get definition, proper definition in here. So you can download it. And if you have any doubt, please write in comment box. Thank you for watching.